That's what we've been hearing a lot lately about the amount of money the U.S. owes and that we're nearing our credit limit of $14.3 trillion. Now, experts predict we'll hit that limit on August 2nd. That means the country will run out of money unless Congress and the president agree on a plan to raise the debt limit.
Here to talk with us about all of this and the impact it can have on us as Iowans is financial planner Kurt Pearson. Thanks for coming in this morning.
Good morning.
So what is your opinion? Do you think it is important that we raise the debt limit? Why or why not?
Well, unfortunately, raising the debt limit is a sum of all of the other, in my opinion, poor decisions that have been made leading up to this. Often give the best financial advice, which is to spend less than you earn and do it for a long time. And that's good, sage financial advice. Well, unfortunately, if we're in a business and they don't follow that advice, the business will go out of business. Our government has not been following that advice, and so now we're trapped into a corner. And yes, we almost have to raise the debt ceiling at the moment. But boy, we better take it as a warning that there's some significant action, especially as it relates to the entitlements, which make up about 50% of the country's budget, that really have to be addressed in the short term.
Okay, how are the markets reacting to this? Because they have to think about the now, but they also have to plan ahead.
Well, I think it's going to increase the volatility here during the summer months. We're in the puppy days of summer. The dog days are in August. But during the dog days of summer, there's low volume, typically enhanced volatility. I think we're going to enter that time period a little bit early this year, just because of this uncertainty. Now, last night, Moody's came out with a warning that the grading of the U.S. bonds may be downgraded. Well, the market is kind of shrugging that off in pre-market trading this morning. So the market's kind of assuming that we're going to get some kind of a deal done by the August 2nd deadline, maybe a couple trillion in spending cuts. And that's merely just kicking the can down the road. But to the markets, that would be a win.
That's interesting. What would you say, okay, say the federal government does not reach the deadline, does not reach a deal by the deadline. How would us as the average Iowan, what kind of impact would we feel?
Well, it might dramatically impact some of the valuations, for example, in our 401ks where we have investments that have been ticking along fairly decent in recent months. It also might impact some of the services that we typically expect from the federal government. It could impact even at the state level some of the payments that they receive from the federal government. And there's a wide disparity of impact possibilities that are being promoted out there depending on which angle you're on.
Okay, Kurt Pearson, thank you very much. Kurt Pearson of Compass Financial. If you'd like to contact Kurt, you can see his information on the screen right now. We'll be right back here on News Channel 8 this morning.